What up, what up? It's your boy Doughxl, tapped in with Aislin Magazine, and this is my April 2021 music playlist. I mean, I got my name from working at a bakery. I named it Baker's Choice because, you know, I consider myself the baker. You know, I bake up classic tunes for y'all to, you know, chill back and enjoy with your family or whatever. So the first song that I'm going to get into is off of my new project. It's the title track called Bayete. You can find that at doughforpresident.com, and it's executive produced by my brother, CT's own Chuck Kennedy. Now, I put this song on there because I feel like, for one, it's a vibe, but for two, I feel like it's a great introduction to me as not only an artist, but as a person. There's a lot of homegrown references in there. It's also got bars, but it still hasn't lost its melodic qualities. So I think it's a very good introduction to, you know, showing people who I am as an artist. And, you know, it's good when I'm spoken to it. 1086 until I die, the capital, the homicide. We don't fuck with no police, homie, we know they trying to slide. With my brody, we Cody's, homie, you know we trying to ride. Stack up chicken, yeah, we do. Shut the time down, then we move. Second song I'm going to get into is Tell It Like. Another track off of my project featuring Hartford's own Sax Fifth and Cool Q, produced by my brother Chuck Kennedy. Now I put that song on there because it always just gets me up and amping in a good mood, and it makes me want to go out and just do stuff. Also, the session was just mad organic, and it just all came together so perfectly that every time I listen to it, it just, you know, makes me think about it. So I threw that on there. I had to tell a lie. Make sure that the battery's good and the skin is red. I had to tell a lie. You shot with the mob to make sure that your blood is right. I had to tell a lie. You hugging my waist, but I'm gripping that metal tight. I had to tell a lie. I smoke a zip to the face on a mellow night. Third song I'm gonna get into is How High by Method Man and Redman. Now, I put that song on there because that was the first rap song I learned from top to back. I know that song so well, like if somebody put a gun to my head and told me, yo, you gotta sing one song without messing up, that would probably be my choice. Like, I really love that song. And I'm a huge Method Man fan. He was definitely my favorite out of the Wu, but it's my unpopular opinion. Billboard, I'm a bullet on my block. How you dope when you pay for your billboard spot?
Look up in the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane.
It's the funk doctor spot, smoking on the train.
How high?
So how that I can kiss the sky? Fourth song on my playlist that we're gonna talk about is Take It In Blood by the greatest pop, Mr. Escobar himself, Nas. I put that song on there because to me personally, it's one of my top five favorite songs, and it's not number five. Everything about it is just perfect to me, from the hook being just the classic hip hop sample hook, to the beat, just the chill vibe. It's just so good for just those long car rides that I find myself taking very frequently. I made it like that, I bought it like that, I'm living like that. You whack MCs. Currency is made and trusted, a messiah. I'm spinning it to get higher, earth, wind, and fire. Singing reasons why I'm up early, trustworthy as a nine at bus early. Sunshine on my grill, I spill. Fifth song that we're gonna talk about is Kush by Lil Wayne. Now, I threw that on there because it reminds me of 8th grade, point blank, period. 8th grade was when I first got introduced to my love, Mary Jane, and this was the song me and my peoples used to listen to daily, every single day. It was just Carter 3 for me, that's it. Lil Wayne, to me, is the greatest rapper alive, still. No one's finna tell me anything different, so I had to put him on. And I smoked that Kush. Yeah, that Kush. And a ball like swoosh. Yeah, like swoosh. Spodeyody Dopealicious by Outkast. I honestly didn't really get into Outkast until my senior year of college. And, well, not my senior year. It was like closer to like freshman, sophomore when I really, really, really started doing the knowledge and I started listening to Outkast heavy. And this song was one that just stuck out. I mean, I love heavy instrumentation on songs. And I just also feel like the fact that they hopped on the song and instead of just, you know, putting raps over it, it was more of like a spoken word, and just getting those two different perspectives between Andre and Big Boy is just, it just really stuck out to me and it was amazing. So always like to listen to it when I'm chilling, relaxing after a long day. It really puts me in that zone.
This is just my interpretation. of the situation.
Last but not least, what we're gonna talk about is Late by Kanye West. Now, I threw that on there because honestly, greatest Kanye West song ever. Argue with me about it. Now, I love that song because it resonates with me, not only being a former student and that song getting me through so many times, but it's just I've never heard anybody, and honestly, to this day, I don't think I've heard anybody explain the student life as well as Kanye West on that song. It's just the little things. Like when he said, you mean I missed my major by a couple of seconds? He said, not even prerequisites, not even electives. Man, y'all don't know that struggle. If you ever signed up for a class too late or signed up for classes too late, got registered too late, and there ain't no classes left, so now you stuck in the basket weaving with everybody else underachieving. Y'all know my pain when I listen to that song, man. It's definitely a banger, timeless classic, so.
They said the best classes go to the fastest. Sorry, Mr. West, it's no good classes. And that's what your ass get. Not even electives, not even prerequisites. You mean I missed my major by a couple of seconds? Now I'm in the shop class or the basket weaving with all the rest of the motherfuckers underachieving.
That's it. My name is Doughxl. This is Aislin Magazine. Go to doughforpresident.com now. Get by Ate, executive produced by my brother Chuck Kennedy. Doughxl on Instagram, Doughxl on Twitter. Holla at me.
I'm back.